We are super excited about our next guest, and there is no better way to introduce him than taking a look at some of his best work.
He's weaved musical magic through the Disney films we know and love. When I shake hands with you. Together with his brother Robert, legendary Hollywood composer Richard Sherman has written some of the greatest movie musical numbers of all time. Bang, bang, chitty, chitty, bang, bang, our fine poor fender friend. His incredible life story even made it into the recent Hollywood hit movie, Saving Mr. Banks.
Responsible is not a word.
We made it up.
Well, unmake it up.
Detailing the story behind the making of Mary Poppins.
He pretty much wrote the soundtrack to our childhood, and he's here to chimaroo with us, joining you. Joining us from Hollywood Live this morning is Richard Sherman.
Good morning.
Welcome to you, sir. We must say thank you for all of the joy that you've given us over the years. You and your brother Robert wrote so many Disney classics. What was it like to work in those golden days?
Thank you. I tell you, it's a great joy to be representing my brother and myself with these songs, because we had a great deal of joy writing them, believe me.
Richard, I'm just beside myself because I love your songs. They make me laugh, they make me smile, they make me cry. And I love to the supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. How did you come up with that?
Well, I tell you something. It was not an easy job, because we wanted to be, what we wanted to do was give the Banks children in Mary Poppins a souvenir to take out of a make-believe world. They had jumped into a sidewalk drawing with Mary Poppins and had a wonderful experience. And so we wanted to give them a souvenir to take out of this imaginary place. And we couldn't give them a leaf or a corn paw, anything like that. We couldn't give them a twig or anything. We said, let's give them a crazy word like we used to make up when we were kids. And so we came up with this large, ridiculous word, which we thought would be fun to give to the children. And that became a very, very definite word for us.
But it is just extraordinary. I mean, as a bit of a word nerd myself, to actually have invented a word.
Like
history will remember this word. It is now part of the English language.
Yes.
It's part of the lexicon. It's part of countless kids' lives. It actually means something. Like, how does it feel to have created a word and the best word ever?
Well, I say, first of all, it had a lot to do with the fact that we had this wonderful story to work with, and we wanted to give a reason for this these children to have a talisman, a thing to take out of this magical place. And when Bob and I were little boys, we used to make up double talk words like cobble flobble slobulation, and people would say, what does that mean? And we say, aha, that's a secret. And so we said, let's give them that same kind of a thing. And we wanted a big obnoxious word, and obnoxious is not very nice. And we said, how about atrocious? That sounds very British. So we started with that. We said super colossal, and that's corny, but super is good. If we said something in between, so we came up with califragilistic. It just sounds like double talk, which is what it was.
So,
and then
scientific.
We rhyme atrocious with precocious, because you're smart if you're precocious. And that rhymes with docious, why not? So we had sort of like the back end of the song, and then we wound up at the front end and filled it all in with double talk.
And of course, everyone can say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, but only very few can say it backwards. Mm.
But I can. Docious ali expiistic fragicali rupus.
Hey!
Actually, Julie Andrews taught me how to say that. Oh, she's the one that did it.
Richard, the movie Saving Mr. Banks was just absolutely delightful, and I'm going to confess I actually cried at the end, much to my children's dismay. But
they were happy tears.
It was such a beautiful movie. Although I got the sense that P.L. Tavers was not exactly an easy person to work with. How true to life was that movie? I mean, for example, did she really insist that you record all of the conversations?
Actually, that's very true. She wanted every single bit of knowledge that she was going to spew at us to be recorded. And in a way, she sort of hoisted herself on her own petard, because many of the things that she said were absolutely kind of like weird. I will say she you wouldn't believe that a woman would say, I don't want the color red in a movie. But she did. She said that. And it was recorded. So there it is, along with so many other things. Mrs. Travers was complicated.
that's been very generous.
Richard, just finally, I'm a huge cat fan, and another one of my favourite movies of yours is that Aristocats.
Oh, well, Aristocats, that was a lot of fun to write. Actually, the title song was something that was particularly special because it was the last time that Maurice Chevalier ever recorded a song. And we wanted to have this, the man who was represented Paris. You know, he was so perfect to be the one to sing it. And he came out of retirement and did it. And I was very, very thrilled that he did.
Oh, well, I tell you what, we all are so thankful for speaking to you this morning and also for your lovely tunes that have kept us going and made so many people, millions, billions, I would even say, the world over, so happy. Richard Sherman, thanks so much for joining us.
It's a joy to be with you. Thank you.
Gentleman was he. What a gorgeous, gorgeous man. And as a special treat for our studio audience, it's just been released on DVD, so thanks to Disney. You are all going home with Saving Mr. Banks.